Good day to all of you, and we will continue with Francis Bacon's essay of studies. In my previous lecture, I had talked about how, according to Bacon, studies gives us delight, how it enhances our thinking, speaking, and writing abilities, and how it adds charm and refinement to our personality, how it sharpens our intellect, how it helps us to judge things and to go about life's business in a more capable and better way. Now let's continue. And I'll quote from his essay and then explain what those lines means. So I quote over here: "For expert men can execute and perhaps judge of particulars one by one, but the general counsels and the plots and marshalling of affairs come best from those that are learned." Now here Bacon is talking about how studies make a person scholarly and learned. He says that knowledge enables the learned men to critically examine issues and then to arrive at the right conclusion. Now, how do they do that? They become learned because they have studied extensively. They have read widely. And with that knowledge, they are able to examine the different issues critically and weigh the pros and the cons and then arrive at the right conclusion. How do they do this? They do this by collecting data, collecting facts, and rationally and logically examining things. And such intelligent analysis of facts improves the quality of their judgment. I quote again: "To spend too much time in studies is sloth. To use them too much for ornament is affectation. To make judgment wholly by their rules is the humor of a scholar." Now, sloth means laziness. So here he says that if a person spends too much time just reading, studying, acquiring knowledge, it can have undesirable consequences. Why? Because excess of everything is bad. You do too much of something, it's going to lead to undesirable consequences. So here he says that if you indulge or if you spend too much time in just studying and reading, what is it going to do? It is going to make a person indolent and lazy. And to use them too much for ornament is affectation. And he says overuse of that wisdom, that is, in every little thing, in every decision of your life or commonplace issues that are there, in every little matter, if too much of wisdom is used to analyze it, What is it going to do? It is going to make a man pretentious. Affectation means pretentiousness. It's going to make him vain and proud. Then he says that to make judgment wholly by their rules is the humor of a scholar. And he says, if a person sticks too much to rules, that is, he is just going by the rules, not considering other facts, then what is it going to do? It is going to lead to derision or criticism from other people. So he's saying in other words, he's trying to say that one should not stick just to the rules only to assess situations without considering other factors. And to decide on a course of action, one has to use other things as well and not just stick to the rules. Because if one sticks to just rules, it is going to invite a lot of derision and criticism from others. I quote again, they perfect nature and are perfected by experience. For natural abilities are like natural plants that need pruning by study. And studies themselves do give forth directions too much at large, except they be bounded in by experience. Now, here he is saying, what do studies do? He's talking about the benefits of studies. What do studies do? They add finesse. They add perfection to a person's personality. Also, to human nature. They refine human nature. And are perfected by experience. That is, he's saying that the experiences in life, what do? They hone or they refine the nature of a person. Because a person's natural abilities, whatever he has, needs to be pruned, abilities, habits which need to be cultivated. Now, he gives an example for that. He says that just as plants or the grass in a garden needs to be cut or the plants need to be pruned for them to look beautiful and presentable. Similarly, he says studies also, what do? They add refinement and charm to a person's personality. So one has to work upon the inborn abilities that he has so that they can benefit him. And studying, he says, is the whetstone that sharpens our abilities. And it sort of prevents us from making wrong decisions or misleading conclusions. And he says that in such situations, one's experiences in life come in handy to arrive at the right conclusion. Because what he's trying to say over here is that studies, just the theoretical knowledge, may sometimes lead a person to make wrong conclusions or it may mislead him. Just plain knowledge. So he says that in such a situation, what happens is the experiences of life come to his rescue, and these experiences help him to arrive at the right conclusion. So experience is very valuable as it supplements a person's knowledge and wisdom. We'll continue next time.